punish Yazid and his officers and the people who killed Hussein and his families and companions.
Imam has one all.
I will become kafir of that Allah who is not going to be just in avenging and punishing
Yazid.
And I'm not just making a statement on a personal level. I think this is our belief. And so we have to be very clear that when we talk about hope and books, love and hatred, we are talking about love and hatred for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not for the personal and individual, sides that we have with people and issues and events in history. Salawat. In Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has talked about la'anat.
So this is
and many times he says, La'anatullah ala al-kafirin, ala al-zalimin, ala al-mukadzibin. The concept is there.
Question,
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala even, he talks about Abu Lahab and his wife. You read this surah, Tabbat Yada Abi Lahab bin Wattab. What is that? It's the whole, basically, a short surah of the La'anat on Abu Lahab. The word La'anat is not there, but Tab itself. Is a very biggest la'anat that Allah can give to someone.
I will ask you about
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when time comes, He makes it very clear that these are the people. And in many ayat, He describes that those who do this and this, on them be la'anat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So even the names are there sometimes, the description of the acts is there, and then the concept of la'anat and cursing those people is part of the teachings of the Quran. Even if you see the example from Amir al-Mu'mineen, you go and look Nahj al-Balagha, I'll give you two references. One is khutbah number 19, and the other is the khutbah number 135. If you want to look for the word la'anat, otherwise there is much more than that without the use of the word la'anat. Even if you look at the khutbah number 3, where Amir al-Mu'mineen reviews the khilafat of the people before him. There he describes it. It is really, you will say, is this
don't realize that when we talk
can
about
he be so, in our terms, so mean when he's describing that? Yes, he can be. For the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He can be. He can be, kind when he's dealing with his own murder. But he can be very angry with those people when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given him that right to be, angry and upset with those people. There is one khutbah, number 19, where Imam is talking to a person by the name of Ashraf bin Qais. Where Imam was giving a khutbah and he stood up.
Which is important.
And he basically said, "Oh Ali, what you are saying actually, you are criticizing others. This fits on you."
Send them to madrasa.
And so Imam responded to him, and one of the words he says, "Alayka la'anatullah wa la'anatul la'ineen."
That seems that
Ali is saying to that person, only on his face, on you be the la'anat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wa la'anatul la'ineen, and the la'anat of the people who do the la'anat.
If the vows brings them back to
now you can say, well, maybe he would have done Tawbah before he died.
In the seeking of knowledge,
so the issue is that sometimes the la'anat is there, required. In Khutbah number 135, where there is a discussion going on between Uthman bin Affan, the third Khalifa, and Amir al-Mu'mineen, and one of the friends of Uthman, where the friend, of Uthman makes a remark against Ali, and there Imam says to him, Al-Mughayra bin Akhlas, that's his name, Imam addresses him by saying, Yabna al-La'in al-Abtar, you are the son of Al-La'in, and you are the son of the Abtar. And so this is there. We cannot always look at the Prophet of Islam and say he's rahmatun lil alameen. Quran has says very clearly, Muhammad Rasulullah wal ladina ma'ahu, the Prophet of Islam, Muhammad, and he, those who are with whom, those who are with him, they are ashidda'u ala al-kuffar wa ruhama'u baynahum. They are very strong. When it comes with dealing with the enemies and kuffar, but they are very kind when they deal with one another. So there are two sides of the issue. We cannot just always see one side and say, well, this is it. Because this is the trend these days, we will just say, take one side of the Quran, or one side of the Seerah and the example of the Prophet, one side of the example of Amir al-Mu'mineen. No, we have to look at both sides. There is a concept of hub, love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the concept of bugh, hatred for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Salawat wa
sallam.
Tomorrow night we'll be talking about, we'll be talking about the Qatilin of Imam Hussain Ali.
He actually came from a
just trying to get more people tonight, tomorrow night. You know, so we are not even talking about Khulafa, we are talking about the Qatilin of Hussain. And on that issue, if you look at the Sunni scholars, majority of them are those who believe that it is jais, it is permissible to curse Yazid and his followers.
When it did not work,
there are more books written by Sunni scholars showing the permissibility from the Islamic point of view of cursing Yazid than the books written by Shias, because we don't need to read the proof. For us, it is part of being a Shia to curse Yazid. But for Sunnis, this was not. And so they had to, there was a lot of debate and discussion. And there are many, many. Ahmad bin Hanbal, one of the Imams of the schools of Ahl Sunnah, Mullah Ali Al-Qari, one of the experts of Hadith, Al-Tafazari, one of the famous theologians of the Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah. He also believes, and I'll give you his statement later on. And all those who are unbiased scholars of history in the Sunni world, they agree on this issue that it is ja'iz, permissible to do la'nat on Yazid and his followers and his army.
This thing is the wealth.
We actually have one book by Sibt ibn al-Jawzi, a Sunni, and the title is very interesting, where it says Ar-Rad al-Mutaassib al-Anid al-Mani' al-La'n Yazid. This is a refutation against the Mutaassib, the biased person who is preventing the La'nat on Yazid. So this is a book written against this issue of the people who are saying you cannot do La'nat on Yazid. And this is a discussion going on among the Sunni scholars themselves.
You know, many times.
But there are some.
Greed is there.
There are some in the Sunni world who are biased and they have hatred towards the Ahlul Bayt. And they go to the extent of saying that it is haram to do La'nat on Yazid bin Mu'awiyah,
which pushes us to the way.
And one of the most famous among them is Ibn Taymiyyah. Ibn Taymiyyah lived in the 7th century of the Islamic era, and he is the one whose ideas were used by the Wahhabi school of thought, which is now, you know, the dominant group in Saudi Arabia. And Ibn Taymiyyah is one who goes to the extent that I'll just read his words to you. He says, this is the height of bias towards the Ahlul Bayt. He says, فَيَزِيد لَمْ يَأْمُرْ بِقَتْلِ الْحُسَيْنِ. Yazid did not order the killing of Hussein. وَلَا حُمِلَ رَأْسُ بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ. And Hussein's head was not brought in presence of Yazid. وَلَا نَكَثَ بِالْقَضِيبِ عَلَى صُنَايَاهِ. He did not use his stick to hit on the teeth of Imam Hussein. Rather